Hi everyone, this is Maverick Paul, the chemistry guru. Now in this video, we want to go through balancing the redox reaction using the half equation method. Let's take a look. Now we have an example here involving the redox reaction between MnO4- and I- to give me MnO2 and I2. So if I want to balance this redox reaction in acidic medium, basically these are the steps that we need to do. First thing, I have to decide who gets oxidized and reduced, and I have to split them up into two half equations. So if I look at my MnO4-, the oxidation state for my manganese is a +7. To Mn2+, oxidation state for my Mn is a +4. So therefore, this is a reduction, a decrease in oxidation state from +7 to +4. Then I- is a -1 oxidation state, to I2 is 0. So there's an increase in oxidation state from -1 to 0. So what this means is I can split this into two half equations. My reduction half equation will look something like this, my MnO4- to my MnO2. So this is a reduction half equation. Then my oxidation half equation will look something like this. I have my I- split to give me I2. So this is my oxidation half equation. Then the next thing we do is we use these steps that we have listed here to balance each of these half equations in acidic medium. So we balance the element first that gets oxidized or reduced, then we balance oxygen using water, hydrogen using H+, and then charge using electron. Now the reason we balance oxygen and hydrogen using water and H+ is because the redox reaction that we're dealing with mostly is in aqueous medium, so we have a lot of water, obviously, and if it is done under acidic medium, then you have a lot of H+s. So we can easily and we can safely use water and H+ to account for my oxygen as well as my hydrogen. So if I look at this reduction half equation, what we need to balance first, according to these four steps, is my elements. Mn is on the left-hand side, there's one. Right-hand side, there's also one, so Mn is balanced. The second step is oxygen using water. So left-hand side, you have four oxygen. Right-hand side, you have two. So you need two more oxygen on the right-hand side. So I balance it, I add two water on the right-hand side. Then next, I balance hydrogen using H+. So right-hand side, I have four hydrogen. Left-hand side, I need four H+s to balance my hydrogen. Then lastly, I balance charge using electron. Left-hand side, MnO4- is -1 charge, 4H+s plus 4 charge. So overall, left-hand side is positive 3 charges. Right-hand side is neutral. So when I add electron, remember electrons are negatively charged. I have to put it on the left-hand side of the half equation. So I need 3 electrons on the left-hand side. Then this would be the balanced half equation for my reduction. Now, a way to check is reduction is defined as the gain of electron. So I would expect the electrons to be found on the left-hand side of the half equation. This MnO4- gain this electron to become MnO2, so therefore MnO4- is reduced. Now how about my oxidation half equation is also fairly straightforward. I- and I2, first step I balance elements, right? So I need 2 I- on the left-hand side. Then oxygen using water, no oxygen to balance, so we can skip. Hydrogen using H+, no hydrogen to balance, so we also can skip. Charge using electron, left-hand side is a -2 charge, right-hand side is neutral, so I need 2 electrons on this side. Then this oxidation half equation is also balanced. Oxygen is defined as the loss of electron, so I will expect the electron to be found on the right-hand side of the half equation. So I- to become I2 and then lose all these electrons, so therefore this is an oxidation. Once we have the oxidation and reduction half equation, the next thing we can do is we can try to add the two equations together. Now remember, redox reaction is defined as an exchange or transfer of electron. The species that's being oxidized will lose a certain amount of electron. 100% of it is being transferred to the species that's being reduced. There's no remainder. So we need to make sure that when I add the two equations up, I must make sure these two electrons will cancel away. So I have 3 electrons here. I have 2 electrons here. So basically what we do, very simple, I just find the lowest common multiple and I modify each of these half equations. So my reduction half equation, I need to double because lowest common multiple is 6 in this case. Then the second half equation, the oxidation half equation, I need to triple so that later this will work out to be 6 electrons. This will also work out to be 6 electrons so the electrons can cancel when we add them up. Then after that, what I can do is I can add the two equations together. So the reduction half equation is MnO4-. I need to double, right? Because the reduction half equation, I need to double. So this would be 2MnO4-. 4H+s, I need to double. So this would be a +8H+. Electrons will cancel, so I can leave it out. oxidation half equation, 2i minus times 3. So this would be 6i minus. So reactants are done. So we move on to the product. So MnO2 double. So we have 2MnO2. 4 water, 2 water double. So this one is 4 water. I2 times 3. So this is 3I2. So the next thing we do is we look at equation and see whether there are any terms for us to cancel. Usually, the common terms that we need to look out for will be water and H+, because these are the species that we introduce when we balance by half equation method. So for this equation, there are no common species for us to cancel. So this will be the balanced redox reaction in acidic medium. Now, what if I want to balance a redox reaction in alkaline medium? Now, basically, it is almost exactly the same as that for balancing redox reaction in acidic medium. What we do is we just add an additional step. After we get the overall equation, you just add OH minus to neutralize the H+, and then we simplify from that. So what we have based on the previous example, this is the balanced equation that we had in acidic medium. So if I want to balance this reaction in alkaline medium, then basically what I do is I look out for H+s, and then I add OH minus to neutralize the H+. So in this case, what you notice is I have my 8H+ here. So how do I handle it is I add 8 OH minus so that I can neutralize this H+, then this will become 8 water. Now we know that if the equation is balanced and I add 8 OH minuses on the left hand side of the equation, then I must add the same amount of OH minus on the right hand side of my equation to keep the equation balanced. So therefore I need to add 8 OH minus on the right hand side. Then after that I find terms to cancel. Usually water is the one that we look out for. I have 4 water on the right hand side, I have 8 water on the left hand side, so this one I can cancel, and then this one I can cancel, then it will be 4 water on the left hand side. Then I just simplify this, I get the overall redox reaction in alkaline medium. So basically what I do is I just tidy this up. In alkaline medium, the equation will look something like this, 2MnO4 minus, and then this will be 4 water and 6I minus. To give me 2MnO2, then 3I2, and 8OH minus. So this would be the redox equation in alkaline medium. So this is how we balance a redox equation using the half equation method in both my acidic medium as well as my alkaline medium. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel for more weekly video lessons. That's all for this video. I'll see you next time.